united, able, proactive. Dear friends and colleagues in the profession, this fiscal year 2019-2020 has been a year of challenges, an extraordinary success, and a continued commitment to our vision and mission of uniting all Filipino architects both in the country and abroad. Our Get an Architect Advocacy campaign was quite a visionary approach and became apparent over the past two fiscal years. It has uplifted the architect status quo in the eyes of the public, especially our regional architects across the country. Indeed, an extraordinary success from an out-of-the-box idea of this leadership. A humble campaign, but a powerful one. At the near end of the fiscal year 2019-2020 upon us, I must say, I am one of the blessed ones. Not only do I lead an organization that has created historic edifices, but for two fiscal years, I have been living my life sharing my time and knowledge to empower and inspire others to pursue excellence. Because we give to the degree of what we really love. A year of challenges. Over the past few months, our opportunity to gather together and celebrate significant milestones that we had achieved and implemented for this fiscal year has been significantly changed. We have experienced an unprecedented time in the history and transformed our way of communication because of the coronavirus COVID-19 pandemic. Adjusting to changes carried by this coronavirus are indeed challenging to all of us. We are urged to accept and adapt to what is the new version of normal in these times of uncertainty. Many of our planned events and gatherings from chapters level up to national level for the last two quarters of this fiscal year were postponed with no definite time. And this regrets deeply saddened me. But I hope this will not change our positive perspective and rapport to one another. That these regrets will be part of us to become a better person and even things to be getting better. As what the Bible mentions in Jeremiah 29, verse 11, "For I know the plans that I have for you, declares the Lord, plans for welfare and not for calamity, to give you a future and a hope." It is certainly true that the winds of transformation were not always blowing in our favor. Nevertheless, what we're always showing off are our ability to emerge smarter, even better, and stronger community of architects that our excellent works continue and flourishing no matter the weather is. My hope remains on the horizon and working together as one. One community is time-tested. We can use this moment to define what our organization will be look like when going forward and sustaining our position for the future. Thus, I am truly proud of how our chapters around the globe responded safely and positively to this pandemic. From the challenges we have faced, the fiscal year 2019-2020 has also exhibited how significant our collective work is. By uniting for our purpose, we are able to create an extraordinary impact that we ever could do separately. As your national president of this great organization, it is my duty to provide the general membership a dedicated and transparent overview of all the initiatives, efforts, challenges, and opportunities this leadership accomplished for the fiscal year 2019-2020. Last year, UAP was awarded the PRC Most Outstanding Accredited Professional Organization for the 8th time and the only APO to win the award back-to-back-to-back thrice. Also, our Get an Architect Advocacy campaign was honored here by the Philippine Council of Associations and Association Executives ang SUSI Award of 2019 under the Catalyst Change category. And our architectural profession was recognized abroad through the European Business Assembly 2019 and uplifted the profession and its members. Several projects have been implemented in support of this advocacy program, such as the architectural branding, the mascot named Arki, various Bayanihan Arkitektura or CSR activities, the LGU coordination on our Republic Act 9266, media partnerships, national newspaper publications, TV and radio talk show guestings, huge billboards on EDSA, provincial and city highways, out-of-the-box ideas among others, and implementation of the architectural permit in various local government units all over the country in leaps and bounds that many architects benefited from these programs. This leadership then had a 5-point agenda continue our efforts in sustaining the priority programs and projects for our members. Number one, educate the UAP members on the Architecture Act of 2004. I had this desire to educate our UAP members, let them understand and at the same time encourage them to be concerned on our law. Educating them is a watershed moment that the licensed architect is the sole arbiter of the architectural practice. Through this, we empowered our members by educating them of Republic Act 9266 and all of its provisions. To have a bigger audience, we launched the UAP Media Kapihan Forum last February 18. 2020, that as Kapihanan Arkitekto, with various brand partners and media practitioners representing the print, broadcast, and digital media covering the build and design industry. Number two, go and educate the local government units, the mayors, and sangguniang members on our law. I am happy that our UAP chapters and districts are now proactive and steadfast to educate the respective NGOs on our law and the role of the architects in nation building. Last fiscal year, we had made several courtesy visits to our lawmakers and legislators to bring to their table the concerns of our profession, especially on the Philippine Building Act, the Architectural Code, and our law for its full implementation. Last February 4, your UAP had made its courtesy visit to good Senators Panfilo M. Lacson and Senator Win Garcellian, and also other senators such as the office of Senator Grace Poe and the office of our Senate President Vicente Soto to lobby our position on the proposed Building Act, as the five bills will greatly affect the practice of different allied professions, and more particularly, practice of architecture. For the first time in congressional history, more lawmakers championed bills during this fiscal year to strengthen the full implementation of our law. Proof of these tireless efforts and dedication of our UAP chapters are, number one, the issuance of executive order of the Sorsogon Governor Francis Joseph Chis Guevara Escudero for the full implementation of Republic Act 1966 to all municipalities of the Sorsogon Province. Number two, Bohol Governor Attorney Arthur C. Yap issued a memo circular directing the city and municipal mayors to implement the RA 1966. Number three, the recent advisory from the Office of the Building Official in Cebu City, the implementation of Section 32 of our Republic Act 1966, that the new form of the architectural permit will be in use and the signatory of such will be duly signed by a registered and licensed architect, effective March 1 of 2020. And number four, the Legazpi City Council passed a resolution for the adoption of the full implementation of Republic Act 1966, otherwise known as the Architecture Act of 2004, and Presidential Decree 1096, or the National Building Act, or National Building Code. Number four, the Architectural Code has also been filed in Congress. And number five, several cities and municipalities all over the country have already implemented the architectural permit, some of which are the municipalities and cities in the Camarines Norte area, particularly those that were pushed through by the UAP DAET Camarines Norte chapter, and also in other places around the country. I hope that at the very soon, all our efforts, time, and resources placed in our long overdue campaign for the implementation of our Republic Act 1966 and other related laws affecting our profession will become fully realized. Allow me to inspire all of you with this message. While we are all waiting for our case in court to be decided upon on who is the right professional to do vertical structures for man, the Bible mentions the word wait or waiting 141 times. It doesn't mean we will just sleep under a guava tree and wait for the guavas to fall like Guantaman. In fact, the Bible states while waiting, the Lord wants us to use our time, talent, and treasures productively and purposeful. In Ecclesiastes, it is mentioned, in everything, there is a season and a time for every purpose under the heaven. So use our God-given abilities to uplift the profession, promote and make society know that there are architects, and push our architectural branding into the limelight so that architecture will be known to the public. And if we do these things collectively and positively, I know our desires will be granted by the Lord because we have used our waiting time productively. And in His time, He will make things happen. So you see, it is all in the perspective of things, of how people view what architects do or each other's point of view. We have to distinguish ourselves, our profession, from that of other allied professionals, that we are distinct and different from their professions to be appreciated by society. Number three, do corporate social responsibilities for society, particularly the local government units as a country. The UAP encourages our members and chapters to regularly reach out to the underprivileged. CSR is the heart of our organization. To create positive impact on social, economic, and environmental aspects, it is important that we keep a good heart. I sincerely appreciated the efforts of our Bayanihan Arkitektura Committee for their time and free services rendered in the school complex rehabilitation and construction of Bito Elementary School in Marawi City, together with ABS-CBN Lingkod Kapamilya Foundation. Also, the UAP National was fortunate that our Emergency Architects Committee had also done their fair share in coming up with alternative temporary shelters for COVID-19 patients. And a lot more, such as the collaboration with GMA Kapuso Network, working for the rehabilitation of Dato Saber Elementary School in Marawi. I am proud also that all of our UAP chapters from local and abroad, including our UAP National, had a good heart in helping out our kababayans affected by the COVID-19 pandemic. Disasters, natural or man-made calamities, not only through provisions of goods and free services, but also bringing their home back and helping put that smile on their faces. Thus, CSR is what really matters. Number four, promote and advertise the profession. Let architecture be known to the public. The best way for our profession to advance is through education and awareness. Every UAP event, every project is an opportunity to spread the transformative power of architecture. Number five, partner with the business sector in uplifting the profession, the members and society's welfare. Your UAP values the connections and collaborations with private and commercial entities in furthering our goal. It makes society realize that architects do not only draw beautifully, but also exposes the reality that architects are also excellent project managers, hands-on social and community development personnel, analytical and complex organizers, and also member-centric. On our continued efforts to let architecture be known to the public, my heartfelt gratitude to our industry partners such as Davis Paints, Wilcon Depot, rain or shine, sky bees, nipple paints, ground pipes, HEG sanitary wares, City Hardware Inc., Livable Cities Philippines, among others, to uplift our profession and become our industry channel to promote the role of architects in the society. To all my fellow colleagues from the National Board of Directors, Executive Directors, past National Presidents, officers of the College of Fellows, jury members, chairpersons and members of various standing and special committees, chapter board officers, and the many indefatigable volunteers of UAP, including our UAP National Secretariat, our friends and partners in the industry who have been working with me to make these extraordinary services possible. Maraming salamat po. With your unremitting support, this report tells our countless stories of accomplishments. Together, we successfully conducted all national events such as the Asian Architects in the Academe Assembly in 2019, the World Architecture Day, the National Architecture Week, and the return of our UAP National Conference of Architects. We are now on our road to the 50th Golden Jubilee of UAP. And to our architects in the Academe, we thank you for attending the Architects in the Academe Virtual Assembly Year 5. And it was just quite unfortunate that our 45th National Convention did not push through because of the COVID-19 pandemic. We have partnered with the Livable Cities Philippines to provide advice and assist cities competing in the Livable Cities Challenge as mentors from the professional industry. The challenge vision is an accelerated trend towards designing, building, and developing competitive, sustainable, and resilient Philippine cities. Through this, our mayors and key local officials are encouraged and motivated to develop comprehensive, replicable, and implementable solutions to improve the livability of their cities while strengthening local community in the process. Together, we continuously partner with the Manila Times as our media collaborator for the publication of the weekly column of the UAP Architects Perspective. I am also proud that in my two-year term, our UAP will have now a collection of the Architects Perspective, a single volume containing various articles written by different architect members and authors. Together, we expressed our full support to the PRC, the Board of Architecture, and CPSP Architectural Council regarding the formation and organization of specialty societies. We have also entered into the Memorandum of Agreement with various institutions such as Nippon Paint, Sky Cable Corporation, Anthology Festival, the Metrobank Foundation for this year, Art Made Public, which served also as a pre-CPD seminar for the UAP members. Together, we represented the organization and participated in various international opportunities such as the Asian Congress of Architects, the ASEAN Architects Council meeting, and Arcasia Committee meetings and roundtable discussions. Together, we had attended several committee meetings of the Committee on Public Works and Highways at the House of Representatives and drafted comprehensive position papers submitted to the Senate and House Representatives during my fiscal years concerning filed bills. We pursued the UAP visualization policy for a property investment in Mindanao to reach out and be of service to the regional architects, especially in the South. And last year, together, we chartered 15 chapters. And this fiscal year, these 15 chapters are the following. New Manila Centris Chapter, QC Commonwealth Chapter, Buglas Sur Chapter, QC Ubedlawin Chapter, Bataan Peninsulares, Bacolod Azucar Chapter, Nueva Ecija Palayan Central, Pasig Capitolio, Sidio Himulogan, Bagumbayan Chapter, Cavite Aguinaldo Central, Bukidnon Caabulan, Manila Nakpil, Samar Northwest, and the Boracay Chapter. I would also like to congratulate also the formation of two chapters during this year, and this is the Ilocandia True North and the Pangasinan Dumaay chapters, both from Area A. We are all called to this destiny to be united and driven by the same goals, by the same passion for architecture. Let us inspire peace. Peace among all of us so that we can move forward as one. There will be unity. Inspire kindness. Thus everyone will see the goodness in each of all of us, and hopefully your kindness will radiate to others, and they in return will radiate that goodness to more people. And lastly, inspire gratitude. Always give thanks with a grateful heart, even how big or small the blessing is. Know where it came from. Know also where we are coming from. And know also what best position we will, that we can influence others positively. I encourage everyone and every Filipino architect to deliberate on the proper role and position of architects in the built environment. Advocate the quality of your professional services and product. Encourage architects to embrace the spirit and letter of our laws. Formulate guidelines with clear objectives, criteria, and methods for sustainable architecture and built environments. Raise awareness and practical knowledge among key stakeholders. Develop diverse initiatives to promote architectural social responsibilities and promote design solutions, especially now COVID-19 is upon us. I am of the firm belief that UAP and its members will come together in this time of crisis. My battle cry for this is simple: stand together, stand stronger. That is what we all must do. We must turn back this adverse situation into a positive opportunity for all of us. We will all watch our backs together. As I step down from the UAP National Presidency, I would like to leave to all of you some very good news. Good news that our prayers, efforts have been answered. Since filing our case in the Supreme Court in the year 2013, this had been languishing for quite some time with little movement. For those in the know, we had such an exhilarating time moving our battle, going up the ranks cautiously and meticulously. We had felt then that the Supreme Court would be able to look at the merits of our case, since we believed then that justice was not favorably dispensed at the lower court. With a few but important personalities believing in our goal and standing by us or pushing us in the right direction, we fervently realize that the architects should make architecture be known to the public so that those who dispense justice or believe in justice will be able to distinguish and appreciate what architects do, distinct and different from our allied technical professionals. The Get an Architect campaign advocacy, together with our out-of-the-box educational awareness and our strategies to promote the profession, I would rather say were quite effective the past 2 years that may have contributed in the realization of our case in court, coupled of course with prayers and dedicated architects and personalities working on this. A certiorari filed by the UAP to review our position on who is the right professional for the practice of vertical structure, the practice of architecture in the Supreme Court was granted to us. God forbids, if the certiorari was not granted, that would have been disadvantageous to the profession, as that would have meant the court did not appreciate our presentation before them and upheld the lower court's decision. As it looks now, this initial victory of ours gives us the position that the Supreme Court believes our case has merits, and for us to finally have our memoranda rendered by our UAP lawyers for them, the Supreme Court, to decide on it. And we pray it will be favorable to us. It may not be unusual for the court to grant a certiorari, but I believe they may have seen something in our case that should merit a positive response. So let us pray for this, as now our case has been leveled up, and pray that a wrong will be righted in due time. As I near the end of my term as the first regional architect from Mindanao to be the UAP national president, I can now sleep well and rest well as I prepare to transfer the responsibility of this office to the incoming national president, Architect Renato A. Herrai, who has been a tested, loyal, and dedicated servant of the UAP. My congratulations to all the incoming members of the National Board of Directors, and may the blessing of our Almighty God be with you always and give you the necessary wisdom and strength to make any challenges ahead into a resounding victory. I can now say to myself, day in and day out, for 2 full years that I have given my all to this beloved organization, trying not to relax, not to be complacent, not to be a mediocre servant leader of this highly multi-awarded organization, and always seeking out, pursuing excellence. There is a much higher calling, a much higher purpose than just trying to be the best organization. After being bestowed by the Professional Recreation Commission the award for the most outstanding professional organization during my first fiscal year as the UAP National President for the 8th time, or even the most outstanding professional organization and also the most outstanding professional association by the Association Executives, the Philippine Council of Association and Association Executives, or the first international award received by UAP by the European Business Assembly. This higher calling is actually the trust bestowed upon us when we took our oath of office. Architects believe in us, casted their votes for us, and that is why we should not fail their great expectations. Fellow architects and friends in the industry have said this to me so many times. Even when there are architects who have started negative remarks, because after all, that is what they do best, or lost their hope, dedication, and faithfulness. My zealousness, my enthusiasm, my positivity, and shining examples of how to do things best, be there when needed, or be there when least expected by the membership, go the extra mile for service to the member organization, that is an inspiration and upliftment of their spirits and empowering those architects who believe in you. And so, I totally agree. I firmly believe our Get an Architect campaign advocacy has changed the thinking of society. And now, people and our clients now have begun to realize and distinguish the works of the architect and even started looking for architects for their projects. All we have to do now, as always, is to be productive in our work, show passion, and above all, do things positively. I would like to thank the chapters, the various chapters, for their participation in the Get an Architect Advocacy Campaign. You are so numerous, and I'm pretty sure all of them, all of the chapters in the UAP have been participative in this endeavor. And on the implementation of our Republic Act 9266, by going to the local government units and the support also of past national presidents such as Architect Mediliano Boy Roldan, Architect Gimoy Sancha, our chairman of the Board of Architecture, Robert Sack, and other past national presidents on the education and implementation of our Republic Act 9266 with all the other chapters, including our visits to the various local governments. I would like to thank all those chapters that have exerted efforts reaching out to the local government units in order to implement our Republic Act 9266. Fellow architects, I have sacrificed a lot on the promotion of our profession. I have sacrificed my family, and I have also sacrificed my professional work so as to give a better life for all of us architects. Up to today, I have mentioned, I have not yet been with my family for 4 months already. And at this time, I have always felt that service is what is in my heart, and I am disheartened to know that there are some members who do not appreciate the service we have been doing to the organization. But deep in my heart, I have always felt that service is indeed a blessing. Maraming salamat po sa inyong lahat sa pagsuporta sa akin national board, sa amin lahat, sa UAP at sa atin architects advocacy during my 2-year term presidency. I may not be able to thank all of you personally as you are also plenty. But rest assured that all of you will be in my heart and in my mind. Or, sa hugot lines pa yan, Minsan, ang pasasalamat ko sa inyo ay nakikita ng puso at isipan at hindi nakikita ng mga mata. Maraming salamat po sa inyo. May our profession stick in the hearts and minds of society. Mabuhay kayong lahat. Mabuhay ang arkitektong Pilipino. God bless UAP. Good day, fellow architects. Today, I address the statement of the UAP National President on the acquisition of real property in Davao City. I am pleased to announce the UAP's purchase of a piece of land located at Maha in Davao City that was consummated last March 2020 before the unexpected implementation of the Enhanced Community Quarantine or ECQ in Luzon due to COVID-19. This will be the future site of the UAP Regional Office in Mindanao in order to cater and serve the members in the regions. Eventually, the plan is also to purchase a piece of land in Cebu and to build a regional office for Visayas to serve the regional architects. Even in the future, for also possible properties for regional offices in Northern Luzon and Southern Luzon by future UAP administrations. At the beginning, during my assumption to office in 2018, as the first national president from Mindanao, my only desire is to serve this great organization under the banner United, Able, and Proactive, and to uplift the Filipino architects globally. My slogan then was to let architecture be known to the public. This past 2 years, we have achieved historic milestones and expanded the reach of services and advocacy. We did this as one UAP and as one team. Every day, we leverage our intellectual resources to address real challenges facing our profession and our organization, all in an environment that nurtures a sense of belonging and a responsibility to this institution we share. As I am about to end my term as the UAP National President and look back at the past 2 years, I am proud to see that so many of the innovative ideas and initiatives outlined in the plans and programs are taking deeper root and flourishing. The Get an Architect advocacy campaign we have done in the past 2 years have uplifted the architects in the eyes of the public and catapulted the architectural profession to greater heights. The Get an Architect campaign advocacy had been quite a visionary approach. Several out-of-the-box ideas such as huge billboards in EDSA, provincial and city highways, and on DIY stores. National news publications, even talk shows and TV guestings. Lobbying in Congress and protecting the profession.
partnership with the business sector, educating the local government units on Republic Act 9266, and implementing the architectural permit in offices of the building officials are but some of the activities. I appreciate the various chapters supporting these programs of the current leadership. You and I bolstered our leadership team, deepened our commitment to a culture of belonging where everyone feels valued and adds value, and launched specific programs and efforts to cross-pollinate commitment and understanding. We expanded our promotional campaign and opportunities for members, ensured that our organization remains to be the prime professional organization of architects. In summary, our endeavors this past 2 years have pursued a bold new course for institutional collaboration among officers, members, and stakeholders. I must say, we have achieved remarkably because of your great support and cooperation. So that is what we mean when we say UAP is exceptional. Not that our organization has been flawless from the start, but that we have shown the capacity to change and make life better for those who follow us. And to my committed national board, whom I dearly always rely on, it has been the honor of my lifetime to be your national president. And we all owe you a deep debt of gratitude. With this commitment, I suffered loneliness in the four walls of our great building since March 17, the time of COVID, lockdown in Luzon. Until today, I have not yet seen my family for 4 months already because of the COVID lockdown. And honestly, these past few weeks have been confusing and painful ones for our organization and to the office of the National President. I know you have doubts in your minds about what happened in this whole episode. What I hope is not in doubt, however, is my commitment to present to you all the details concerning our actions, concerning our desire to institute regional offices in Visayas and Mindanao. For the information and guidance of everyone concerned, the purchase of the Davao property was a result of a lengthy and meticulous process. The decision to purchase properties in Davao and Cebu was in line with the UAP regionalization policy, which has its roots in past administrations. Under the leadership of then National President Architect Rosano C. Rosal, fiscal year 2012 to 2014, UAP was tasked to identify, create, and accredit UAP regional offices in each district for better, faster, coordinated communications of the district directors. The leadership of then National President Architect Guillermo H. Sancha, fiscal year 2016 to 2018, then introduced a program of to institutionalize UAP regional offices. When your present leadership assumed office, it decided to continue the same noble program as part of its commitment to serve the numerous UAP members in the regions and to ensure maximum participation of all chapters and members through the establishment of regional offices in the Visayas and Mindanao. and hopefully in later years also for Northern Luzon and Southern Luzon required areas. Thus, 8 months ago, in October 2019, the UAP National Board unanimously approved the purchase of properties in Cebu and Davao and tasked the Land and Building Management Committee to lead a search for suitable properties. During the National Board's February 2020 meeting, the chairman of said committee recommended to the National Board that UAP purchase a piece of land in Davao City located right next to the busy intersection of Eden Street, which is a four-lane diversion road, and the new bypass four-lane road with an area of 331 square meters surrounded mostly by commercial and residential buildings. This recommendation was well received and had no objections then. It was this very Davao property recommended by the chairman of the Committee on Land and Building Management that UAP bought on March 7, 2020 for 8.5 million pesos. The purchase price and other costs, including legal fees and government taxes, were well within the 10 million budget allocated by the National Board. I would like now to address the speculations and questions supposedly being raised by our members on social media as to why UAP is making purchases of real property when there is an ongoing pandemic and economic crisis, and our funds might be better used for other more relevant purposes. It may be appropriate to recall at this time that when the decision to purchase the Davao property was made back in October of 2019, the SARS-2 virus had not yet even been identified. No one has yet contracted the COVID-19 disease, and talk of a pandemic had not even started. There was no controversy then. Everyone in the National Board agreed, without objection, that UAP should push through not only with the purchase of land in Davao, but also one in Cebu. The chairman of the Committee on Land and Building Management was able to find a suitable property that he recommended to the National Board. Again, when the recommendation was made by the chairman of the Committee on Land and Building Management in February of 2020, everybody on the National Board agreed without objection that we should purchase this property that was recommended. And that is what we did. After seeing the property and its supporting documents, and after due diligence, I was convinced that the purchase of the property recommended by the Committee of Land and Building Management to the National Board of Directors was indeed a good deal and advantageous for UAP. The sale pushed through on March 7 of 2020. Contrary to the allegations that the Davao property was bought in haste, I beg to disagree here. In several occasions, I have spoken on this openly on several fora, starting with the planning session in June of 2019, Inaugural 2019 on Financial Solvency, National Conference of Architects or the NCA in October of 2019, the World Day of Architecture also in October of 2019, and National Architecture Week for the now in December of 2019. Various chapters and district activities and meetings, the area assemblies in 2020, and even chartering of new chapters. The National Board, through the National President, conducted due diligence and had the documents verified prior to signing of the deed of sale. The documents presented were the original owner's duplicate title, tax declaration, cancellation of real estate mortgage, latest tax receipts, real property tax certificate, and other relevant documents. Local lawyers also helped us with the verification. The sale was above board, involved an undisputed title with excellent potential within our price range, and hopefully will benefit UAP members and future generations of members. Those of you who read the Inquirer newspaper dated May 30 of 2020 know that the week before, there was a series of articles extolling the potential and benefits of purchasing land in Davao, calling it an attractive property investment hub. It appears now that the most prevalent sentiment on social media, the social media group, is why is UAP purchasing land at this time, when our colleagues may have other more pressing needs caused by the ongoing COVID-19 pandemic. It is easy for everyone to look back in retrospect, criticize the National Board, and second guess the purchase of the Davao property, saying that it was insensitive on the part of UAP to be spending money on property at this time. But I request the second guessers to all look back at the whole process. In October 2019, before COVID even existed, there was already a unanimous decision to buy land in Davao and Cebu. In February of 2020, when COVID was already starting to spread in other parts of the world, there was still no hesitation on the part of your National Board to proceed to buy Davao land that was recommended. Let me show you the detailed timeline on the acquisition of real property in Davao to establish a regional office in Mindanao. As presented, the timeline for the acquisition of real property in Davao to establish a regional office in Mindanao. So on June 1 of 2019, during the annual pre-planning and corporate planning sessions of 2019, one of the programs of this administration envisioned to implement is institutionalized UAP regional offices, which were formulated during the UAP corporate planning workshop held on June 1, 2019, as part of the administration's commitment to serve the members in the region. On September 14, 2019, during the second regular executive committee meeting at Newtown Plaza Hotel in Baguio City, Execom Resolution Number 12, Series of Fiscal Year 2019-2020, with the title Resolution Approving the Purchase of Real Property in Cebu and in Davao in the amount of 20 million for the establishment of regional offices in Visayas and Mindanao respectively. On October 17 of 2019, during the third National Board of Directors meeting at the farm at Carpenter Hill in Coronadal, South Cotabato, Board Resolution Number 3-32, Series of Fiscal Year 2019-2020, is the resolution ratifying Execom Resolution Number 12, Series of 2019-2020, approving the purchase of real property in Cebu and in Davao in the amount of 20 million for the establishment of regional offices in Visayas and Mindanao respectively. On November 28, 2019, the UAP National President sought legal assistance from the UAP lawyers, Poblador, Bautista, and Reyes Law Firm on the legality of the action on whether UAP can purchase real property and allocate funds for the acquisition pursuant to our bylaws. And in December 7 of 2019, the National Board of Directors, in its regular NBD meeting in Pampanga, approved the minutes of the October 2019 NBD meeting without any corrections and or amendments thereto. On January 11, 2020, during the 4th Executive Committee meeting held at Dahilayan Forest Park Resort in Manolo Fortich, Bukidnon, Execom Resolution No. 25 Series of Fiscal Year 2019-2020 with the title Resolution Approving the Chairman of the Committee on Land and Building Management to travel to Cebu and Davao to make ocular inspections and submit recommendations on the properties to be acquired pursuant to National Board Resolution No. 3-32 Series of Fiscal Year 2019-2020. On January 30 and on February 1, 2020, during the Area C Assembly in Cebu, the National President, in his speech to the general membership, informed the participants and delegates regarding institutionalizing regional offices in Visayas and Mindanao and the recent approval of the National Board to purchase the properties in this area. On February 4, 2020, the Chairman of the Land and Building Management Committee proceeded to Davao for an ocular inspection, evaluation, and assessment of the 11 properties submitted by the 3 licensed real estate brokers in Davao. And on February 20, at 8:30 in the morning, the Management Committee meeting at the 5th floor of the Office of the National President at the UAP National Headquarters, the Chairman of the Land and Building Management Committee presented to the Management Committee his report and recommendations. And on February 20 at 10 o'clock in the morning, during the 5th National Board of Directors meeting at the UAP National Headquarters, Execom Resolution No. 25 Series of Fiscal Year 2019-2020 with the title Resolution Approving the Chairman of the Committee on Land and Building Management to travel to Cebu and Davao to make ocular inspections and submit recommendations on the properties to be acquired pursuant to National Board Resolution No. 3-32 Series of Fiscal Year 2019 was ratified during the NBD meeting to Board Resolution No. 79. The Chairman of the Land and Building Management Committee presented his recommendations to the Board, which had no objections from the National Board of Directors members. On February 29, during the Area D Assembly Conference of Mindanaoan Architects 2020 in Butuan City, the National President, in his speech, informed the participants and delegates regarding institutionalizing the regional offices in Visayas and Mindanao and the recent approval to purchase the properties in this area. On March 3, 2020, the Secretary General physically signed a Secretary's certificate at the UAP National Headquarters on March 3, 2020, to terminate the peso money market fund with the Banco de Oro Timog Victoria Towers with account ID number UITFI9192661 and proceeds from this account to be immediately transferred to the UAP current account with Banco de Oro of Timog Victoria Towers for issuance of payment to the seller of property in Davao and for legal fees and government taxes. On March 4, 2020, in reference to the National Board Resolution Number 3-32, a secretary's certificate signed by the Secretary General was submitted to the bank for the issuance of a manager's check in the name of the seller of the Davao real property amounting to 8.5 million. On March 6, 2020, the National President, coming from the chartering of UAP Samar Northwest Chapter in Tacloban, proceeded to Davao. And on March 7, 2020, the National President met up with the seller of the real property in Maa, and upon rechecking all the documents, consummated the transaction of the sale. On March 12, 2020, during the 5th Executive Committee meeting at the UAP National Headquarters, the National President reported the status of acquisition of lands for the UAP regional offices with the Davao real property already purchased. And on April 22, during the 5th National Board of Directors meeting via Zoom, and this was the first online video conferencing, the National Treasurer informed and reported to the members of the National Board of Directors that the UAP 2 weeks or 1 week before the lockdown has already purchased a real property in Davao worth almost 10 million. At that time, I was the only officer here at the UAP headquarters. Also, the National President informed the body that the Cebu property will be placed on hold and reiterated that the Davao property was already purchased. On May 21, 2020, during the 6th Executive Committee meeting via Zoom video conferencing, the second video conferencing, the National President mentioned to the Execom that in the last April National Board, he reiterated again the status of the property in Visayas was placed on hold. The property acquisition in Davao was consummated prior to the coronavirus lockdown and is just waiting for the titling of the property. On June 6 of 2020, there was a special National Board of Directors meeting via Zoom video conferencing. And here, NBD Resolution Number 105, Series of Fiscal Year 2019-2020, was a resolution ratifying and confirming the purchase of real property in Davao, particularly the property in Maa, Davao City, for the establishment of the UAP Regional Office in Mindanao. And also on June 6, 2020, during the special National Board of Directors meeting via Zoom video conferencing, NBD Resolution Number 106, Series of Fiscal Year 2019-2020, was a resolution holding in abeyance or place on hold the purchase of real property in Cebu for the establishment of UAP Regional Office in the Visayas. On June 13, 2020, the National President presented a comprehensive report on the acquisition of real property investment and the UAP regionalization policy for information and guidance of the members during his personal forum with the chapter presidents, NBD members, and guests via Zoom video conferencing. And on June 17, 2020, the titling of the real property in Davao in the name of UAP or United Architects of the Philippines as per NBD Resolution Number 105, Series of 2019-2020, is currently being processed with the Land Registration Authority in Davao. Once titled, the transfer certificate of title will be turned over soon to the UAP National as a real property investment. And on June 19, 2020, under the audited financial statement for fiscal year 2019-2020, the total acquisition cost of the property, cost of property including government taxes and other related fees paid, will be reflected as investment in real estate, similar to the real property in number 53, Scout Rallius Barangay, Langinganda, Diliman, Quezon City, or otherwise known as the UAP headquarters. Even at this time, UAP bought the property on March 7, 2020, there was no issue. Of course, now, at this time, everybody is aware of the deaths, the hardships, and the devastation that COVID-19 has caused and may continue to cause. But back then, on March 7, there was still no ECQ, no GCQ, no orders to work from home, no orders to wear masks, and no quarantine passes. COVID-19 was not yet declared a pandemic, and no travel and social distancing restrictions were yet imposed. The total number of confirmed COVID cases in the Philippines then was at 5. Now, there are over 27,000 cases. If we were to purchase the property, the Davao land today, in June of 2020, I would be among the first to join our brothers and sisters on social media who feel that it would probably be more prudent to postpone the purchase of the property. But back then, in March of 2020, there was no reason not to proceed with the purchase of the Davao property. Again, at that time, the National Board had a pending duty to fulfill its October 2019 resolution to purchase the property in Davao that was recommended to it. And this is exactly what we did. Now, the whole scenario has changed. COVID-19 has adversely affected many of our members all over the country and those working abroad. We commiserate with their situation. We assure everyone that we are all on the same side. In fact, at its meeting last June 6, 2020, the National Board passed a resolution to hold in abeyance the purchase of the Cebu property. Indeed, we can all agree that now is not the right time to purchase land. The succeeding administrations should find ways to look at the health and welfare of the general membership. For everyone's information, it has also been made a policy by the National Board to suspend the establishment of regional offices pending review of the impact of COVID-19 on our organization and our members. The UAP regionalization policy, as valuable as it is for all our members in the respective regions, will be for the next administrations to take up at the proper time. I hope and pray with all of you that COVID-19 will be eradicated soon, that we can return to our normal state of affairs, and that the succeeding administrations can one day revisit our UAP regionalization policy. Leaders have been praised for immediate impact brought to their members. The Get an Architect Advocacy Campaign is one of such example of immediate impacts that propelled architects to the forefront of the design and build industry. Yet, the UAP regionalization policy takes time to develop. Acquiring properties and building regional offices to service the members matures with time. This is one vision that regional architects and progressive architects understand by heart and deeply appreciate. Until then, we call on our members to be united. Despite our current difficulties, work together as one community and wholeheartedly trust and support the succeeding UAP administrations and officers as they guide us through these challenging times. I am reaching out for unity among all the architects of the UAP. As we move through this difficult time, we hope to find some new ways to maintain our sense of community and connections. We greatly value your patience, your empathy, your creativity and resilience as we face these extraordinary challenges together. Maraming salamat sa lahat ng chapters, National Board of Director members, commissions and committees, at sa buong general membership. Mabuhay ang UAP, mabuhay ang arkitektong Pilipino. On June 25, 2020, the Register of Deeds in Davao City issued a transfer certificate of title in the name of the United Architects of the Philippines for the property in Davao City.